thanks so much for stopping by. This evening I'm going to show you how I put that pattern onto a wine glass that I just did on the black cardstock last week and posted it. And this is a sample of one of the glasses that I've done already. And I went ahead and just did a funky, cute little stem decoration down to the base of the glass. I love how it turned out. I think it's just such a fun glass. Great entertainment piece. Something that would be fun to entertain with or make a great gift for the upcoming holidays. All right, let's get started. Tonight I am using the Thicket Green. This is the folk art enamel glass paint, Wicker White. And then the Berry Wine. And this is multi-surface paint, which is the Perido. I like to use that along with the Thicket for my leaves. What I'm going to do is start off with pouncing with my Scruffy brush. The base of the actual flower part I'm going to tap onto my glassware. Keep in mind too, as I say each time I'm doing a video, no two pieces of glass will be identical when you're painting them hand by hand, or by freehand, I should say. So keep that in mind. Make sure you share that with your customers if you're selling your glass pieces. And I'm going to, this will be, I'm going to do basically two of the bigger flowers and then have two buds. Or what I would say would be buds, and I'm just kind of making those a little bit thinner, not as round, more narrow. And then I'm going to do that on both sides here, just sporadically tapping on, no specific placement. And then continue on with a bigger, more rounded tapping of the Berry Wine. Ended up being like a pretty glass. You know, I know a lot of times I use these color combinations. I really need to kind of get away from that and maybe do more mixing and such, but I love it. Now, basically, I'm going to use this round brush, which is my larger round brush, and go ahead and paint the floral designs on. I'm going over it with the wet paint, or going over the wet paint, I should say. You can try to dry it if you wish. If you don't want to go over the wet paint, I like to do it just to be able to bring some of the color from underneath onto it. And I apologize if you can hear my dogs. They're upstairs playing, fighting, whatever, causing all kinds of commotion, which is pretty much, it's evening time, so they have to start. It's always nice when you want to relax and they're carrying on like crazy animals. This is just such an easy design to paint. And just keep in mind, my intention is to do easy designs so that just about anybody can do it. Not to make it so difficult that it's hard for the average person to paint. I'm really, really not interested in that. I'd like to make it to where you can be successful and enjoy what you're doing. Not discourage you, if that makes sense. And this is just really, if you can just, as free as you can be with the design and not be too stiff with it, I think it turns out better. Alright, and then I'm going to go here with the bud and just try to be as free with it as I can, but just make more of an oval or partial oval. I don't want it rounded because I want it to look like all the flower petals are just still kind of bunched up. Now before you paint on glass, just a reminder, make sure that you clean your glass. I do recommend that you at least wash it with soap and water before you paint on it. Or if you are going to, if you want to make sure that all the good stuff is removed, or the bad stuff, I should say, not really good stuff, but all the bad stuff is removed from the outer part of your glass, then make sure that you also go over it with some denatured rubbing alcohol. And then that should really set a good base for you to paint over. And the reason being is that you just want to make sure that any of the like dirt and grime, oil from your fingers or dust, all that stuff is removed before you start painting, so that your paint will adhere better to your glass. And that's really the important part, is to have the paint adhere and stay on. And that will help it do so if you're doing it on a clean surface. Now, if you like my videos, make sure that you're actually subscribing to them. Hit the bell that should be down there also, so that you receive notifications when I post something new. If you like my videos, give me a big thumbs up. Make sure you share this video, or all of my videos, any of them that you view, with others that you think might be interested in what kind of work I do. I would appreciate that also. I'm trying to build my channel, so any help I can get is greatly appreciated. Like I said, and with this type of design, you can just, freely go over it and just keep building on it until you get the look that you want. I just want to make sure that it has enough variance that you can actually see and it stands out. That's kind of the look I'm going for, is just to make sure that you can see it and tell what it is, basically. All right, and then for the next step, when I'm adding my green leaves and other designs, I'm going to be using a number 10 glass flat brush. And that will be using combination of the Thicket, the Perido, which is the more of the metallic green that I like so much. And then what I'm going to start off by doing is actually drawing on some stems. I'm using a combination right now of all three of those colors just to give it some more substance, because sometimes it can be kind of watery if I don't do that. And I, as many of you know, if you've watched my videos, I do like to have more opaque looks to my paintings. You can just do it with the one color if you want, or not one color, but the two basic colors, or if you want to go over it again, which is what I'm doing, just add the variety in there. It just kind of gives it a thicker look, makes the paint a little bit more durable when it's thicker. I'd love to hear from you. Please let me know what you think of my glasses. I really enjoy painting them and sharing this with you, and I hope that you enjoy them as well. When you're painting these, you can either do the light color on the outside or the inside. It doesn't matter. I am doing this over the glass, or over the painted part. I am doing it over the wet paint, so I am pulling some color in from the actual flower. So if you don't like that look, you can either throw a hairdryer on it, a heat gun, whatever you have, and then dry it a little bit so that you avoid getting any of the base color from the flower that's below it. If it doesn't bother you, then just do what you're doing. You know, to me it doesn't bother me because it's nice. Now this one I'm going to actually do the green, the darker, on the outside of the flower or the leaf. And also on this I am putting the white on here. And I'm going to go back here, keeping the green on the inside and the white on the outside. It's kind of, I'm just moving over here and doing the same kind of technique, but on the opposite side, if that makes sense. I like to have a lot of paint on my brush. I don't like that amount of paint. It's kind of hard when you're, I've gotten kind of out of it, to paint on these smaller glasses. It's definitely easier to get down in there on the bigger glasses. I'm just going to keep filling this in with leaves. And again, you can add different kind of leaves. You can reverse the colors that you're doing. Have the lighter on the outside, or in this case, I'm actually going about it and doing the same color combination, but right beside each other. And meaning that, I'm going to add a little bit of white to that to make it a little bit more opaque. In most cases, I would have had the darker green on the outside on both sides. In this case, I went ahead and did the lighter edge on the outside of the actual leaf, and it's not on the inside. So hopefully that's making sense. Now you can do it either way. I'm going to go like that. It has a little bit of white in it because I touched it with a little bit of white. And I can go like this and make it go the same direction. Well, actually it doesn't look like that, but I think that's what it is. I got a little bit on the tip. Go like this. It gives a variance, if you can tell. Now I'm looking at that leaf thinking, huh, I don't know if I like how that's centered. So I'm going to go back over here with the green a little bit and wiggle it. I think I like that better. So then I'll go back over here and draw a little stem through it. A little veining. And here we go. I'm on top of a wet surface, wet on wet. And that time it didn't pull in much of the undercover, if at all. So that's fine. I'm going to keep it going the same direction. So now this side, the outer side, is going to be green. I'm going to have to go back over it. And I'm going to pull this down through here like that. Come back over here, add another leaf. This time I'm just going to do the green on the outside. And then the darker green will be on the inside. You see that here? And we'll pull this lining through there. And then I am going to just continue on. Now on this one here, I'm going to end up doing a leaf over the top of this other leaf, just fine. I'm going to do it in the same direction, so the outer on this is going to be white. Add a little bit more green to the center here. Hope this is making sense. Now I'm kind of talking and right now we're kind of pulling up some color from that, the underneath leaf. And come back here, get some of that. And just pull the stem down through it. And I'm going to come over here and do the darker on the outside. I'm going to keep the darker on the outside again. Just adding some interest to it because they're not all the same. They might be very similar as far as the design itself goes, but they're not all the same as far as the way the colors are placed. Alright, so the next thing I'm going to do is go through here and just add some stems that you will see here in a minute what I'm going to do with those. If you saw my video already of what I did on the cardstock, then you have a pretty good idea already what's happening here. And I'm just going to go around the glass and just keep adding it wherever there's space, because I like to have the glass filled in as much as possible. Now if there was more room, I could do something more, you know, swervy. I like that. And then add it up here. You know, just have fun with it. I mean, that's the main thing, is to have fun. Don't have to be serious. I'm not doing brain surgery. Thank goodness. I'm glad I'm not. Alright. Because then what you're adding on top is going to take care of this. And here it comes again. Let's do it this way. Come down here. And then it's going to swim up here. Go like that. Over like that. Whatever direction you want it to be is fine. However full you want it to be is fine. You want to add more. Again, a lot of it's going to be covered up with what we're going to be doing next. Now, on this next step, still using the same brush, I'm going to start adding my little filler flowers. At this point, I'm doing the green. When I'm using the green, the darker green is on top right now. And yes, I am going over the flowers a little bit, which that's fine. All's well. It's okay. And then you can reverse it so that you're getting more of the metallic is showing more. And that's the lighter of the two colors. Okay. And then I'm going to go in and have the thicket green and some of the wicker white and just tap it in. All this is kind of filling it in and it's giving it more interest. Because there's a variety of colors here. I mean, not wild colors by any means, but a variety of color. And I like it. I like it like that. And I can even reverse it to do more green on the outer part, which I'm not going to at this point. Not going to. I'm going to add some down here a little bit just to fill it in. Go back in with some of the, like I did before, with some of the metallic, just to kind of fill it in a little bit. See how I did that? Alright, I'm going to move on to the next bit here. I'm going to start with my darker. I think I got myself into the, well, I think I took some of it off the flowers, what it amounts to. Alright, I'm going to lead with my green and just keep doing it here. by the time you turn the brush and go in a variety of ways with it, you're going to have it. It's going to be pretty full, which is fine. You want it to be. And you're going to be on top of that flower a little bit on both sides. It's okay. It's a filler flower. Gives it more interest. Covers up some of the open space. And then I'm going to do the white. Add that in. And again, I think it just fills it in more. Alright, turn in the glass. I'm going to go over here. Start the same thing here. That's why I say the ending of these vines, how I did them, it doesn't really matter because I'm painting over them anyways. And on these, I'm just trying to stick with two colors. I'm not venturing into adding a third color right now. I'm just doing the Thicket and the Perido. I'm going to switch it around. Like I said, these are just so easy to do. Switch them around. Go like that. Give it some interest. And it's just a fun filler flower. Then I'm going to add the white. Do the white with the Thicket. Hopefully you can see this. I'm trying to pay attention to my monitor on top of painting. I'm just hoping that you're getting to see it. But just see how nice that is. I mean, just it fills it in. You're doing something a little bit different. And we'll just keep doing this and repeating. I think we're almost done with this part. Oops, got too much white on that end. Okay, whoops, I'm reversing it. Okay, this time I'm doing the Perido first. Leading with the Perido. Now this vine comes down here, so I gotta make sure I get all the way down there too. And I'm going to turn it around and be leading with my Thicket, which is the darker of the two greens. Again, filling in as I go. And hopefully you're seeing this. And I apologize if for some reason I'm not getting it all on film. I'm trying to. Trust me, I'm trying. I'm trying very hard. Alright, then I'm going to go back. Keep putting pink on my brush. Go back and throw some white in this. And like I said, you can just see where I'm just randomly touching, just very quickly. Just touching down. Depending on how much pressure you're putting, can also make a variance in the petal shapes and size. Okay, did that. Now, one thing that I haven't done yet is just put some basic small little pieces of, or not pieces, but little leaves in, kind of just like the touch and turn kind. And I'll just put a little bit of a, you don't have to add these in. You find that you don't have room. I probably should have added them in prior to painting all the fillers in. But again, it's okay to do this and be over the top of some of the other things that you've painted. Put them in there. I think that's all I'm going to do as far as that goes. I don't get too crazy with it because it's pretty full anyways, as you can see. Now, the next fun part is to get in here and add, do the stem of the glass. And I just, you know, looking at the glass, saying, oh, it's, you know, really pretty. But, you know, what about the stem? Because in some of the glasses I've done recently, I really haven't painted the stems. And I'm thinking to myself, you know, I really like to do some kind of fun. So guess what? This is what I came up with. And again, this is just something that you just sporadically do. I'm just brushing this on, turning the glass as I'm brushing it. And then, I mean, I'm not taping it off, I'm not doing anything, I'm just eyeing it and turning it. So I got the one on. Then I'm going to just use my eyes and just kind of space it out a little bit. Keep turning it as I'm going. Just keep doing it, turning it, pretty easy. I'm basically just doing this one time around. If you want to do it and feel like the need of having to put more on it to cover it, give it more an opaque look, that's perfectly fine. I'm not doing that right now. I'm just putting this on one shot. One shot, and it's just very random, very, very random, as you can tell. All right, so then I'm going to go, just keep moving here. I'm going to go around the base of the glass, and again, even with this, it's just very random. And when I go to put the next set of colors on, they might intermix some. That's fine. I'm not intending them to not do that. I'm not even trying to avoid that, I should say, because I figure at some point they will. Again, this is just a very, you know, if you want to be more particular about it and tape off and do all that kind of stuff, more power to you. Knock yourself out. I'm not even trying to do that. This is not even an attempt to even come close. And hopefully you can see it. I feel like I keep pulling my glass out of the limelight here. And you can smooth them. If you think you got too much paint, you can smooth it down a little bit or try to get it more smooth looking, longer strokes. Whatever is fine. That's what it is right now. Then, and you can wash your brush off in between. I'm really not, but you can. I'm just kind of mixing them together. Kind of wiped it off a little bit and then proceeded. Okay, so here we go. Keeping my color to the bottom. White's going on top, just like I did with the berry wine and the wicker white. And then I'm proceeding to go around. So what you're learning from me is just how to be very unprecise and just wing it. Wing it the best you can. That's all I can say. Right, and then I'm going to go down here, do the same thing. And like I said, you get a little pink in there, that's fine. Not a biggie. Not a big deal. And I think it's pretty fun, festive. Fun and festive. All right, and this is going to be the last ring I do. And just fill this in down here. Trying to fill it in the best I can. Still trying to keep it. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing. Like I said, if you want your colors to be cleaner, as far as not being mixed in with the other colors, then tape it off. You know, that's my best advice to you. I don't particularly care whether it's like that or not, so I'm happy with doing it this way. And so there you have it. And I think they turned out very pretty. Very happy with it. Not a fun gloss, and I think it would be awesome to entertain with. Alright, well, once again, if you like my videos, please make sure you subscribe to them. I'd love for you to share my work. Give me a big thumbs up, and until the next video, I hope to see you then. Have a good evening.